One of the most important concepts in programming is the notion of a data type, which we also just call a type. You've been using types since your first program, so you already know a fair bit about types. We just haven't talked about it explicitly until now. Understanding types more deeply will make you a better programmer, will help you understand more what's going on when your programs run. It will also get you to the point where you can define your own data types, and that will be useful for making our search engine code more modular, like we just talked about. So first, I want to introduce some terminology. Everything that you can reference in a Python program is an object. What does it mean to be able to reference something? Well, that means we can give it a name. There are lots of ways to give things names. You could pass it as a parameter. You could use it in an assignment. Anything that could be assigned to a name is an object in Python. Every object has a type. We can think of types as sets of values, and the type of an object tells us something about what we can do with it. There's an easy way to explore types in Python, and that's to use the built-in type operator. The type operator takes any object as its input and produces as its output the type of the input object. Here's an example. So here we're using type to find the type of the object, which is the number 101. That's an object. We can reference it. We could assign it to a variable. We could pass it as a parameter. So it must have a type. And it has type int, which is short for integer. What you might find a little more surprising is we can do the same thing with functions. So we've defined the function double that takes one input and returns x plus x. See if you can guess what the type of double is before I evaluate this. It has type, and its type is function.